Dear students, we have briefly introduced you to the Microsoft Excel, and today we will be focusing on the available functions and formulas in Microsoft Excel. And these are the formulas which we will be practicing in today's module, like sum, average, min, max, median, count, countif, add, subtract, multiply, divide, and exponent. So let's start the practical. So here is a file, the same file which we were processing in the last module, and I have just written all of the topics over here, like we want to practice sum, average, min, and max, etc. And we also want to go with the add, subtract, multiply, divide, and we want to practice exponents. So first of all, we should understand that anything which we want to apply as a formula in Microsoft Excel, so we can type over here or we can type over here. So both bars are available to us, but it's better if you type over here. And whenever you want to type a formula, so formula will start with a symbol of equal. So whenever you write equal, so it means that Microsoft Excel is getting the idea that you are going to insert a formula. And then, for example, if you want to go with the sum, so just type sum, and you can see that many formulas are being recommended to you. So at the moment, I am only interested in the sum, but you can also practice many other formulas as well. So you can see that whenever I'm scrolling over the formulas, then there is a detail which is being explained over here as well for your understanding. So I'm interested in sum, and after selecting the formula, you need to put a small parenthesis, and then you need to give the range. So we are interested to get the sum from cell number B3 until B10. So I will write B3 colon B10 and then small bracket close. So you also can see that these cells have been highlighted as well. So whenever I will click, so you can see that all of these values have been summed up over here, and you can see the formula. And when you have applied one formula, then there is no need to apply the same formula for next subject. You can simply copy this formula to the next, for the next columns. So one direct way of copying this is you select this cell where the formula is written, and then here you can see a small dot, and if you go over this dot, you can see that there is a different shape of cursor of plus sign. You need to click on this and then drag this to the right side. So all of the sums have been calculated for you instantaneously. So you can see that if I click over here, so it is saying that I have calculated the sum from C3 to C10, and I have calculated the sum from D3 to D10. So all of such sums have been created. Similarly, if you want to calculate the average, click equal, average, and then of course B3 until B10. So it will calculate the average, and then you can see that I have given it as in the format as number and with one decimal place. So if I do it with two decimal place, so it will be shown as 82.888, right? So it will be rounded off if I go with zero decimal place or one decimal place. And then you can also expand this by clicking on that particular dot, and all of the averages have been calculated. You can see that the average of C3 to C10 has been calculated, and average of F3 to F10 has been calculated, right? So then you can also calculate the min equal min B3 until B10. and then you can go over here, right? And we can also go from this direction to left side as well. For example, equal max. So F3 until F10, we wanted to calculate. So this is the maximum value in this, which is with Akmal. And then you can copy from here to in this direction. So you can see that it has applied over here. And then similarly, you can apply median as well. B3 until B10 and going to the right direction. And then you can also count. Count. So it counts the number of cells in a range that contains numbers, right? So it will tell you that in this selection from B3 until B10, how many are numbers? So at the moment we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. In 8 of the cells, there was a number. So for example, if I remove this one, so then you can see that it is now showing 7. So this means out of these 8 numbers, out of these 8 cells, the number is present in 7 of the cells, and in one of the cells there is no number, right? So I can put it over here, and then you can go in the right direction. Of course, whatever is the range, we have all of the 8 numbers. And then COUNTIF is an interesting thing. So if you use COUNTIF, it counts the number of cells within the range that meets a given condition. So for example, if I want to search with B3 until B10, and my criteria is, for example, 98. So you can see that there are 2 students who have got 98 marks. So Ajmal and Saqib. So these 2 have got 98 marks. And you can also say that I am interested to get all of the students who have got more than 60 marks. So there are 6 students who have got more than 60 marks. And then of course you can copy this number over here. And then you can see one interesting thing, that when you have calculated all of these functions and applied those formulas, so if I change in the data, so that change will be reflected instantaneously in the result. So for example, you can see the maximum number over here is 96. So let's try to change this 96 to 100, and then you will see that at the same time, this 96 will be shifted to 100. Yes, and its average has also changed, the sum has also changed. So whatever change you make in these in this data cells, so all of those changes will be reflected over here. And then to add, subtract and multiply, this is very simple. Equal, so for example, we want to add i4 with j4, so i4 plus j4. So remember always to put equal before the before your writing, when you are starting to write formula. And then I have done like this, and then subtraction equal to i4 minus j4, right? And this subtraction is available. And then I can also multiply i4 multiplied by j4. So this is the result of multiplication. So 12 multiplied 10 is 120. And then I can also perform the division, i4 divided by j4. So you can see this is the result of the division. And I can also calculate the exponent. To calculate the exponent, I need to use this sign. So I was interested to calculate the exponent i12, which is this, raised to power j12. So what I have written, i12 raised to power j12. So This is a sign which is available normally on all of the keyboards, normally with the number 6. And I have done it. And if I try to expand this, so you can see that 2 raised to power 2 is 4 and 3 raised to power 4 is 81. So dear students, let's conclude today's module. We have learned different functions. We have performed those functions in Microsoft Excel and we have seen the results. So in the next modules, we will be coming back to you with some exciting other options available in Microsoft Excel.